exercises, this Romanian team are the reigning world champions. They beat the Soviet Union and were the first team to do so in modern history. They beat them in Fort Worth, Texas, at the World Championship. And although the Soviet Union are reigning Olympic champions, these are the girls in form. Emilia Eberle, next to go. The range of that split position. Back up to handstand. There it is again. Also neatly composed. It really looks so well rehearsed. It's near perfect. There's that back up rise to handstand. And that's a 9-9. Eberle scores the first 9-9 in the women's championships. Still only 16, 5 feet tall. Tremendous gymnast. The chanting of Nadia, who cuts yet another new figure, I may say, since we saw her last. Well, I'll be surprised if that doesn't get 9-9. She is back and with a vengeance. Looking fuller than ever before at 18 years of age. She's 5'3¼", one of the biggest gymnasts here now. We were worried about her health in Montreal, and rightly so, but worried about her general health as well. And she's got 9.95. What an opener by Comaneci. Nadia Comaneci, the all-around champion of the world, who was beaten by Nelly Kim, the all-around champion in the Olympic Games, rather, beaten by Nelly Kim in world championships, and has come back to defend the title of women's supreme gymnast. This is Rodica Dunca, fifth in the all-around championship of the world last December. Only 15. This is the girl who recently won our champions all, along with Katerina Wrench. Beautiful stand. There's a couple of wobbles there. Quickly into an extension during that somersault. A 9-9. Despite those minor readjustments, a 9-9 for Rodica Dunca. And here is the young lady who has made the beam her own personal stage, even when she was being defeated in the all-around title of the world. She still came back and scored 9.95 on this, despite her injured hand. The noise of the camera shutters must be quite disturbing. on her toes, on the ball of the foot, all time. There's her confidence spin. Beautiful. Specializes in perfection must already be giving these judges some concern. For that looked an immaculate performance. And the crowd wait in anticipation. How do you mark that after the nine nines which have gone before? And they've marked it with a 10. Nadia Comaneci sets her seal on these championships. On the piece of apparatus which she has made her own. There's the first 10. And rightly so, it goes to Nadia Comaneci. 15-year-old Milita Rune. Runner-up to Nadia Comaneci in the Romanian championships. Runner-up to Nelly Kim in the World Championships. Most of the remaining girls, naturally enough, using the same music, although I have to point out that in these Olympic championships, for the first time in the compulsory exercises, there are two pieces of music from which you can make your choice. Emilia Eberle, world champion on floor. Her scores at Fort Worth, Texas were 9.95 and 9.85. The 9.95 coming for her compulsory exercise. Again, beautifully done. Eberle's score, 9.9. And still Nadia to come. Well, her scorecard is looking good. After two pieces of apparatus, she's only dropped 0.05. Personified by Nadia Comaneci. And even though she's put on weight and may be tested when it comes to the dynamics of gymnastics, when she gets into a voluntary routine and the double somersaults with their twist may test her, certainly on this compulsory routine where the balletic movements of gymnastics are at a high premium, she is superb. And her score, 9.95. Just one-tenth lost on three pieces of apparatus. Now for Nadia Comaneci. Extraordinary series of marks. 9.95, 10, 9.95. That's her first fall. Long step forward and an adjustment, I thought, on landing. And an angry response from the crowd. Second ball. Well, that looked better. Marvelous second flight. Listen to the crowd as another 9.95 goes up for Nadia Comaneci. Although her feet were slightly apart on landing, anticipated the landing. But that's a remarkable series of scores. She can't complain at the treatment she's had here in Moscow. Well, with the Russians still to come, look at the Romanian score and look at Nadia Comaneci's score. The Romanians out there filling the first four places. Here, Shaposhnikova, Natasha, 19 now, grown a little, 4 feet, 10 and a quarter. The girl from Rostov-on-Don, Lexi, born in the Ukraine. Followed Turishiva and is coached by her coach. Thank you. Shaposhnikova. She too was injured in Fort Worth in those World Championships. That was a marvellous performance. She is probably the Soviet Union's most creative gymnast, as we shall see as these championships unfold. But she's got a rapturous reception there from the Soviet crowd, and one wonders how that's going to be reflected on the scoreboard. 9.95, and deservedly so. Real atmosphere being created in here now. Nellie Kim, darling of the British team, the darling of the British crowd, and certainly the darling in front of this crowd. Kim, 23 next week, the reigning Olympic champion on floor in magnificent form, and this Soviet team looked very composed, looked very strong, and one has to remember the sadness in their team. Elena Mukina lies critically injured at this moment, injured in training whilst preparing and hoping to make this very, very good team. 9-9 for Nellie Kim. And this crowd were really hoping that she might have made the magic 10. Now, Natasha Shaposhnikova. Nice fall. Lovely one. That really had the crowd gasping. And that, I think, is worth 10. Oh, it's beautiful. It really is blowing. But a score, 9.95. It's difficult to see how it can be bettered. So with 9.95 already in the bag, Natalia Shaposhnikova has her second attempt. It's spot on again. She matches it. And Nellie Kim smiles, and the crowd rise to that. Already in one sense at least, they match the Romanian. Nadia Comaneci has been matched by Natalia Shaposhnikova. And she's climbing on the podium to take that richly rewarded applause. So, the perfect vault. And that's the first time in the history of women's gymnastics it's been done in the set vault. And now for the overall world champion, Nellie Kim. Oh, she makes it look so easy, but I'm not sure that that matches Shaposhnikova. It didn't have the flight. Maria Filatova. Very dramatic gymnast. She got up to the handstand position, straddle out up again. Flies away. Polina Astakova, the coach there, congratulating her. She's grown up quite a lot, this Filatova. She's a tough little firebrand. Picked out as a school child because she was light-footed, quick-witted and daring. No surprise. 9.85 her score. Stella Zakharova. This is the girl that finished second to Nelly Kim in the Soviet Championships. She too, a very explosive gymnast. And the scores are creeping up, and at the end of two pieces of apparatus, the Soviet team were 0.55 ahead of the Romanians. I remind you, though, that they led by 0.7 of a mark at the end of the compulsories in Fort Worth when the Soviets lost their world title. This is Steffi Krecker from the German Democratic Republic, seventh overall in those world championships in December, third in the vault. So we see her vault now. Very fine vault too. She's 20 years of age. She's quite an experienced gymnast, 5'3", tall, well-built girl, a student from Leipzig. 9.95. So the East Germans very much in contention still. Well, as the Russians warm up on the beam, I must say that it's a bit of an unlucky draw for them, because the beam coming last, it's the most difficult piece of apparatus. It's where errors are more likely to occur, and that's what happened to them in Fort Worth. This was the piece of apparatus that let them down then. They're about 0.6 of a point ahead of the Romanians at the moment, but they've got the worst piece of apparatus to come. Well, as Stella Zakharova comes up to the beam, she knows better than anyone that the Soviet girls must stay on and must score well. She's had a string of marvellous scores. There they are, 9.9, 9.9, 9.8. Now, at least five Soviet girls must score well on beam to go ahead of the Romanians at the end of the set exercises. Mushina has already been. She scored 9.8. But one slip here, as they had in those World Championships in December, could spell disaster. And the Romanians, of course, scored very well on beam. That's a nice performance from Zakharova. Thank you. 9.8. Well, I'm sure the Russians discussing the fact that they're 0.85 ahead of the Romanians. Maria Filatova. Well, there's rarely been a more confident gymnast than this young lady. Ninth overall in Montreal, came in the team and displaced Lydia Gorbik at that time, who was a lovely performer. When you consider that the Russians have left out Svetlana Groshtova, who I think is a supreme beam artist, it shows a remarkable strength in depth. 700,000 registered gymnasts in the Soviet Union, and 1,000 of those are registered masters of sport. The back somersault there, nicely flighted. Beautifully spotted. Paulina Astakova straight on to congratulate her. And they are willing this crowd on. They want them behind them. Rightly so. And 9-9 the score. Nellie Kim moves forward to the beam, knowing that the team score is all important. She's down on individual scores, despite those 9-9s, three of them. She's down to Natalia Shaposhnikova and, of course, Nadia Comaneci. Nellie Kim, 8 years older than many of the gymnasts here. And she's been in international gymnastics for 13 years almost. Magnificent stand. All the noise in the background did nothing to destroy her composure. The delight for Nellie Kim. Nine-nine. They're staying ahead. Very good scores, these. Another girl on whom there's an enormous amount of responsibility, Natalia Shaposhnikova, last to go on the beam. And not just for the team title, they're 0.85 ahead. She would have to score 9.95 to equal Nadia Comaneci. But if she can stay on the beam and get it together in the compulsory exercise, this is the one girl that could challenge Nadia Comaneci for the supreme title, because she has such daring stunts, such virtuosity when it comes to the voluntary exercises, that she can more than match Nadia. There was a slight wobble and a little pause there. Nadia has looked absolutely magnificent, particularly in these compulsory routines, but when it comes to floor and beam, this girl is more daring, more dangerous, more exciting. And if she gets it together, she could threaten her for the all-around title. She's already ahead of Nellie Kim. So now, they were 0.85 ahead of the Romanian team. She's the last to go in the Soviet team. They must stay well ahead. 9.95, she matches Nadia Comaneci.
After the couple of Soviet Union, Elena Mukhina took only the ninth place. And so she lost a chance to be included to the national team. And so on the practicing meeting in the clinic, she tried to invent the new exercises which she think can help her to be chosen to the team. And so because it's a very interesting exercise, a new one for her, she fall down and made injured.
Will she ever compete again?
I don't know exactly, because she was at the age limit. She's 20, and usually in gymnastics it's time to leave gymnastics, but I'm sure that you can have a chance to make interviews in some moment, some maybe days, when she would be recovered. And
we may be able to go and see Elena Mishkina before we leave Moscow.
No, I think that the injury not allow her to make interview in some days, but I think that month and a half, maybe you will have such possibilities. But she alive. For sure, just this morning I called to the hospital and she sent regards to the girls and wishes to them to go for good performances. And she's looking sports program. And the rumor, bad rumor, is not true.
Enjoying themselves individually and together. And the finale to the opening of the Moscow Olympics provided an astonishing demonstration that was a mixture of sport, entertainment, and art.
Elena Naimushina starts the competition for the Soviet team, and it will be a straight Zakharova, which under the new code of points can only be marked out of 9.9. Good as that was. Cutwell on, and the back somersault off, and she scores 9.6. Maria Filatova. The same vault. Still the tiniest in the Russian team, 4'7¾", but she was 19 2 days ago. Beautiful vault. Absolutely beautiful. This was as near perfect as you can get that vault. Oh, well, feet slightly apart in the first, but look at the flight on that in the second phase where she pushed off. Nine-eight she scores. So Stella Zakharova. Handspring, half a twist. This is Zakharova doing a full twisting Zakharova. And scores 9.75. Elena Davydova, who's 18. And that is almost unique. Full twist on, full twist off. Only Olga Corbett before her has done that vault. She did it in the World Championships at Varna. Made it her own until now. This 18-year-old, who's only 4'10¼", perfects it. Look at that. Full twist on, touches with her hands, spins around, and does a full twist off. And scores 9.9, the highest to date. Now, that vault is marked out of 10. The most difficult vault marked out of 10. She scored 9.9. And she'll now repeat it. Girl from Voronezh, third in her national championships, which probably got her into this team. Oh. wonders what happens to her sense of balance as she's spinning through the air. 9-9. The touch, the second flight, and the spin on. And here's Natalia Shaposhnikova. That was disappointing for her. We're back to the straight Zakharova, but she underturned and fell forward on landing. And remember, this is the girl high on, feet slightly apart, but great lift off, and then slightly underturned. Only 9.3 for her first attempt, and that's a very big gap. The coach has said she must toughen her armor. She is just a little bit vulnerable. Marvelous creative gymnast. Natasha. Oh, better. Oh, what an improvement. She locked it in then. So perhaps she is toughening her competitive temperament. This afternoon we'll find out. And she raises her score to 9.8. Even that disappointed some of the crowd here. It's the 9-8 that is carried forward, the higher of the two scores. Nelly Kim. His mother was a Tatar, or is a Tatar. Father, Korean. She was born in Shurab, in Tadzik. Code there to show the judges which vault she's going to do. Each vault is given a number. The number that has appeared in lights is 43, and that will be the straight Zakharova. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. But she can still only get 9.9, even if it is perfection. 9.75. I think that's why she frowned. It really was superb. Marvelous range of movement. The winner of the vault and floor in Montreal, who was runner-up to Nadia Comaneci, the all-around world champion. Bang. I must say, these Russian girls look as though they can go on producing performances like that all day. 9.75. Big roar in the background. Mexican out and scored 10 on asymmetric bars. While we were watching the Russian girls over there, the bar's just being cleaned off. Mexican out, the little East German girl. There she is. The 15-year-old East German girl, second overall in the World Championships, really is regarded by many as being the next great gymnast, potentially the next Comaneci, the next Kim. And Mexican out scores a 10. Emilia Eberle of Romania, world champion on floor, years of age, just 5 feet tall, and eighth overall in those world championships in December. Through
360 degrees in that handstand position, and then on again. Oh, very confident. Front somersault, more unusual. That backward roll through to handstand. Remember, this is all on a 4-inch beam. We've had the front somersault, flick back, very high back somersault after that flick back. Slight loss of balance. Adjustment, just a little loss of continuity. Double pike, back somersault to dismount. Remarkable what they're throwing, and still trying to retain poise and balance on that beam. Nine that exercise, and that's going to help the Romanians. Wearing number 50. Nadia Comaneci approaches the beam. And she's lucky in one sense in that nobody's working on the floor, therefore there's no music in the background. This is the girl that has scored so many perfect tens on this piece of apparatus. Even more extension than Eberle. More comfortable or more confident on the beam than Comaneci. And the chanting going on as they wait still for the scoreboard. That's that double twisting back somersault. Dismount. Difficult to see where she lost a tenth of a mark. But that sounds close. The team competition is after five pieces of apparatus, 0.75 the Soviet Union ahead of the German Democratic Republic. And they're 3/10 ahead of Romania at this moment. And that scoreboard shows that Nadia Comaneci has taken the lead. Mexican Alcas moved into second place. And Natalia Shaposhnikova has gone from first to third at the end of five pieces of apparatus. That's four compulsories and one voluntary. Filatova. Long swing. Long swing through. Cross-hand change into that front somersault. Looks like a high bar worker. Oh, she went through that like lightning. That really was. Dynamic. This is the most daring gymnast since Corbett. 9-9. Marvelous score. So the Russian girls fighting back. Waiting for Yelena Davydova to go next.
and there's a real buzz of expectation as she goes forward. She really is incredibly inventive. She does a catch-off, that flying back straddle invented by the male gymnast catch-off. She does it. There. One and a half twists straight out of that long swing. She's the only girl to do that on asymmetric bars. It's another brilliant performance. And the crowd are getting behind them now. Long swing. There it is. Flying back straddle to catch. 9-9. Nelly Kim. Kim. I just wonder whether one of those pauses wasn't intended. That was the only minor impediment, if it was such. The rest of it was quite superb. 9.85. Well, maybe there was. And it says much that they ask this girl to go last. They usually leave their best until last. And just as she looks as though she's missed it, she changes from high bar to low bar. Oh, she's lost. She's missed. Definitely missed. Shaposhnikova has had a miss there. No question about that. Because she has a really dramatic dismount, and she knows that she's had an error. Difficult start, and then she included that Delchev, named after Stoyan Delchev. But there was an error. Fortunately for the Soviet team, their backup is tremendous. 9.75, the lowest score. But it will affect her standing, because these girls that move on to the top 36 for the individual championship carry half of their score with them from this championship. And Natalia Shaposhnikova is one of the girls in contention with Comaneci, and she scores 9.8. 15-year-old Maxi Ganauk of East Germany, little girl, 4 feet 10 and a half, who did so well in the World Championships, finished second equal overall. And many feel that she's going to be the next great all-round gymnast. East German girl gymnast they've had since Karin Jantz. And she's world champion on asymmetric bars. And she's had a 10 here on asymmetric bars. Thank you. point readjustment. These are only minor imperfections, but the judging here has been very tough and very tight. Double twist on that back somersault for Maxi Ganap. Incidentally, she's still only 15, and the new ruling that's come out from the Federation meeting here of only yesterday says that in future, gymnasts, girl gymnasts, must be 15 before they can appear in the major championships. Straight back somersault. 9-8 for Maxi Ganauk. Nadia Comaneci walks onto the podium for her floor exercise. The girl who came of age in the 1975 European Championships in skiing in Norway, 4 golds and 1 silver, when she was only 5 feet tall, and then 7 scores of 10 in Montreal. The youngest winner of an Olympic title at 14. She too affected by that ruling, or would have been. Now the new age minimum is 15. Not much doubt about her lift quality with that double back somersault in the pike position. Marvellous dance, tremendous interpretation, and good gymnastics to back it up for those who felt that maybe she was getting a little heavy. That was quite magnetic to watch. This is the true test of whether she's lost any power in terms of her power weight ratio. Look at the lift on this double somersault in the pike position. And she scores 9.9. Well, Nadia Comaneci extending her lead as far as individual points are concerned. Maxi Ganauk in second, Shaposhnikova in third, and look at Nelly Kim, the all-around world champion, down in fifth place. Well, after 6 pieces of apparatus, the Soviet Union have gone further ahead. 1.25 ahead, not of East Germany, but now Romania, who are in second place. 0.45 ahead of the East Germans. Very elegant full-twisting Zakharova from Cristina Elena Grigoreș of Romania there, the newcomer to the team. Only 14, the smallest in the team. And 9.95 for the youngster. Stella Zakharova on beam. These voluntaries, she's had a 9.75 and a 9.8 already. All three teams in contention have such marvellous strength in depth. Even their sixth girl scoring high. How about that for a positive back somersault followed by another? Thank you. beautiful double pipe somersault to this man. That really was. Most confident piece of beamwork. You can just imagine the relief of getting through that. A minute spent on a tightrope. Nadia Comaneci, about to take her second vault, having scored 9.9 on her first. She doesn't really want to be upstage because earlier, Dumitri Turner scored 10 for the Romanians on vault. Oh, spotted beautifully. I'm not sure that she had the great flight that the Soviet girls had, all that Dumitri Turner had. But that's a string of scores, all nine nines, and 199 already to her credit for her first vault. And that certainly matched it. 9.8. Well, her 9.9, it's been changed. 9.9, it's been changed. She doesn't gain from that. Both vaults scored 9.9. Here's Maria Filatova on beam, having seen Stella Zakharova score 9.9. Matured a lot as this young lady. 19 now, 2 days ago. From Siberia. From Leninsk, Kuznetsk.
The six in the team to score in this team championship, remember.
Oh, recovered her composure. Did that two flick flacks to a double back somersault, step forward on landing on the second of the two. She's in a pike position, but she used to be a little firebrand. She's still pretty stubborn and determined, but she didn't lose her composure at all. Maxi Ganauk, next on floor. And there's some real risk and virtuosity in this performance. Her opening tumbling routine is really quite dramatic. There, very rare for a girl to do a triple twisting back somersault. I think that was a marvellous floor exercise. Masses of originality, tremendous degree of difficulty. 9.95 for Maxiganauk on floor. Maria Filatova, her score 9.7 on beam. Here's a girl, too, who excels on floor. Maria Filatova. And she's flying. The same music that she used in Fort Worth. Beautiful. A lot of the cuteness has gone from her repertoire, and she's improved because of it. Matured beyond measure. Maria Filatova, bringing real emotion to this crowd. Even the band have broken their discipline to clap in unison with the rest of the crowd. And Yelena Davydova on floor. That's one of the most dangerous exercises in the book. An Arabian 1 3/4. That is quite phenomenal. The crowd in raptures. There's no holding the crowd, and there's no holding the Russians now. Who can deny them? What a team. They've got 6 Olga Corbetts. That's that Arabian 1 3/4. And that, the timing of that is so critical. Deservedly so. This is incredible. Absolutely original. 1.5 twists and bounds straight into a front somersault. Totally original to her. Yelena Davydova collects the magic 10. Meanwhile, Nadia Comaneci has just fallen from asymmetric bars. Picks herself back up, but in the middle of all that drama, Comaneci falls and loses 0.5. No friendly coach to greet her there. And her overall lead must have been lost now. The real drama, it may be that the music, the sensation, we've got Kachaturian in the background, Shaposhnikova, one of our closest rivals, on floor, and that may have reached even the great Nadia Comaneci. Meanwhile, the overall world champion, Nelly Kim, approaches the floor. And the crowd is suddenly hushed again. And they've lost her music. Oh, the timing wrong. She has the center stage and tumbling routine. And the team title must be theirs, and she's rising in the knowledge. Soviet squad never lost an Olympic team title. Since women's gymnastics has been in the Olympic Games since 1952. And the first time they looked the least bit vulnerable was in Fort Worth, Texas. Now here's their star closing the floor apparatus for them. But they've already had 5 brilliant performances they can rely on. Nelly Kim making absolutely certain of that team title. She still meets Nadia Comaneci in the individual championship, but she knows there are others about who have improved. Maxi Gnauk is up there. Her own teammate, Natalia Shaposhnikova, must be a threat. And the team know that they've got the title. Meanwhile, Nadia Comaneci sits alone with a 9.5 for asymmetric bars. But the emotion and the drama, incredibly dramatic.